neckline we're going to be making on this dress, we're going to be using a slightly thicker interfacing because the fabric is quite fine. Thinner interfacing will not hold its shape on fabric which is flimsy. I'm just going to pin this in place and then use the existing template that we made out of cardboard earlier on. And we're going to use the template. Now this neckline we're going to be attempting to be making is going to be a slightly different shape. So we're going to mark out the few points in here. We're going to work on the same definitions, but we're going to curve it out more into a V shape. Now when making a V neckline, just bear in mind not to make an absolute V. Absolute V does not hang well and you will have problems with the hanging. Also, V necklines tend to hang a little bit deep, so they can be a bit revealing. So just bear it in mind before attempting to make a V neckline. It's a slightly rounded off V. What we'll be doing with this is the excess fabric, and we're going to be ironing this on to the excess fabric. Out of this, we're going to square this, triangle this up. It's a square piece of fabric. We're going to triangle it out like this, and we're going to be cutting half an inch into this on a straight line. Now you can mark this out, but if you put out your cutting, then it doesn't need to be measured out. And basically, this is what we're going to use on the back of the neckline. That piece. Facing underneath, and then iron on from the center, hanging out. The interfacing that we're using for this is a lot lighter weight because this dress is actually going to be lined. We're just going to trim away the excess all around here and also around here. Now we're going to iron this, both the pieces together. Both placed on top of each other, and then pin our neckline piece on top of this. This dress we're making with lining, and the lining and the dress itself we've cut out absolutely evenly. Now before I go on to attach the neckline, I'm just going to put a few pins to keep the lining in place at some strategic points, which is one under the armhole on either side. That's just to keep the fabric in place, and also at the dart points, at the split opening points on both sides. I'm just going to place so that just keeps the fabric in place. Now the neckline, I've already attached the interfacing one. I've overlocked on the edge of this, and placing that on top, I'm going to even this out first, making sure that the fold folds both equally on both sides. Now at the center point, I'm going to pin this, and then I'm going to even it out, pushing it towards the top end, so if there's any excess it will move up towards the top. Again here, and we'll use another pin right at the top because this has got lining and we're sewing two pieces together. So that's our neckline just prepared. What I'm going to do is seam across all the way around here and then put into this. Now I'm not going to be placing darts on this dress because there's embroidery and I'm going to cut into it. I'm going to be placing darts on the back but not at the front. That's our front prepared. These are the sleeves, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do piping. Now the embroidery on this dress is in a green and a peach color, and I'm using peach and green piping. One is proper turnover piping, and then the other one is a narrow, I'm not sure of the name for this, but it's a quite a narrow edging type of piping. So I'm going to be using this on the sleeve edges. Prepared a piece that I'm going to be using for this zip. I've also ironed all this out and prepared it in advance. Lay this open. It's quite visible because this is plain fabric. The crease marks are visible on this. Placing this exactly on the lining. I'm going to be placing a couple of pins again at some strategic points, one under the armhole on either side. I'm going to be placing my piece of fabric that I'm going to be using the zip on. Again, I'm going to pin that into place. And then I'm going to mark this. Now the markings that I'm going to use is from the neck cut, I'm going to mark it down to about 6.5 inches, and then for the zip, I'm going to mark it about 9 inches. So basically, I'm going to stitch around here, and this is where I'm going to be putting the zip in. Now, for the darts, because this dress is lined, I'm going to mark this, and then I'm going to show you exactly what it is that I'm doing as we go on. So 11.5 inches, this is the right side of the fabric actually. So in general, you wouldn't make markings on the right side of the fabric. But because this is going to be lined, I'm going to make the markings because I'm going to do seams across here before I turn it over and put the darts in. So 11.5 here, 11.5 again here. Just mark that across, 8 inches down. And then, once you've marked that, just put a couple of pins just to hold the fabric in place. And that's all the preparations done.